Hello, Windows Universe. In this video, we will talk about if your Windows computer shuts down when watching or playing videos. For a more in-depth look at the topic, we will link an article in the description down below. First, let's verify the graphics card and driver. As it's a graphics-related problem, take a look at the graphics card that is already installed on the computer. Let's open the Device Manager and go to your graphics drivers. First, if you recently updated your drivers and the problem started then, let's look at rolling back those drivers. If that is possible, that might fix the problem. If that's not an option, then click on Update Driver to see if maybe there is a driver update that will fix it. If you are still experiencing the problem, let's try uninstalling the device, restarting your system, and then letting the system reinstall the drivers. Also, if possible, remove the graphics card and then install it on another computer and check to see if you have the same problem on the different system. If it's yes, then it might be time to visit the service center to repair it or replace it. Try replacing the PSU if it needs it. PSU stands for Power Supply Unit, which is probably one of the most essential components to switch on a computer. Without this hardware, it is next to impossible to turn on the PC. It means that if the PSU has some problems, the computer might get issues too. If you're using an aged PSU with other modern hardware, it is the best time to change or upgrade it to something better. The PSU should have the capacity to provide the power supply to each hardware part of your computer. Otherwise, you're still going to get the same problem over and over. Faulty RAM might also be the problem. Faulty RAM can create such an issue frequently. If the computer shows a blue screen of death with memory in the message, it's most likely the RAM, which then needs to be changed. If users have two RAMs and their speeds are different, this also can cause a problem. Monitor your CPU and GPU temperature. Although there's some third-party software to check your CPU and GPU temperature, it'll be best to use the built-in performance monitor tool as much as possible. For the CPU, I decided to use a third-party software called Core Temp. It's an easy download, and we will include a link in the description. This will give you the CPU's temperature, a minimum temperature, a max, and how much power wattage to give you an idea of how your CPU is running. To then check the GPU's temperature, go to the Task Manager. Make sure that if it says fewer details, to go to more details. Go to Performance. Scroll down till you find GPU, and if you look, you should see the temperature of your GPU. If you are getting abnormally high temps on either one of these, contact your manufacturer or take your system in to be repaired. While we have the Task Manager open, let's check app power usage. Go to Processes and scroll all the way over to the right and look for power usage. If you're using Google Chrome or any other browser to watch YouTube, find that entry in the Task Manager. From here, check the power usage trend of that application. Even if watching videos offline, the media player can be found in the Task Manager. Check the power usage and power usage trend columns. If they are showing very low, or moderate, there's nothing to worry about. If they are using very high, then try these things. Disable all extensions. Close all the tabs except the ones you're using. Restart the browser. Use the browser's Task Manager tool to find the culprit and kill it, and then update the browser to the latest version. Next, do a scan for your PC for malware. Sometimes malware and adware can cause this issue. Nowadays, attackers are using countless methods to harm the user experience. Therefore, it is wise to scan the PC for malware and adware. If Windows Defender is not effective in this case, for added protection, you might consider a strong party security suite. Checking the event viewer for the error may help. Type in event viewer, then go to custom views, administrative events, and take a look at all of the events in detail, whether the Windows Update client is not working correctly or the PC is getting turned off while playing a video. Find an error message with some information. It can show an event ID that you can then search to see if you can find what errors might have occurred and where to go to fix the problems. More helpful articles to help you maximize your Windows experience, go to our website, thewindowsclub.com. Do not forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel, where we are always adding new content aimed at making you the master of your digital house. Thanks for watching and have a great day.